I'm outside the Clink Hostel in London, King's Cross, Clink 261. Just got one night here in the pod room. I can't get a video, I'll put a picture up. And today I'm just going to have a walk to the British Museum, have a look around there. Not sure what this video is going to be like, but we'll see. Yeah, so a little walk to the British Museum, and then later on I'm seeing the Smashing Pumpkins at the O2 Arena. So just going to have a little walk around. Got the train in this morning, Long Eaton to London St Pancras. It looks like we've got a nice pub across the road, the Water Rats. I think there is a walk here you can do from King's Cross to Little Venice, but not sure if I'm going to get a chance to do that because I've got some other things planned tomorrow. Yeah, let's go. Yeah, so I didn't realise how close the British Museum is to King's Cross. It's just a 23 minute walk. So I decided to walk, thought by the time you get on the tube, wait for the train and all the hustle and bustle and everything else, might as well walk it. It's working. Interesting apartments.
Okay.
Free Palestine. Expecting that, caught up in a Free Palestine march. Seems to be doing that quite a bit lately. Quite a big turnout for it, it's a big one. Anyway, back to trying to find this British Museum, I think we're far away now. Wow, that was a bit overwhelming. The queue for the British Museum is massive, absolutely humongous. I would advise booking ahead. I booked ahead and apparently there's a another entrance that I can go in to show my ticket, miss the queue. Now the security guard says right and right again. I don't know if he meant down here, no, not down there. Yeah, so definitely book ahead. Queue's massive. So I've got a time ticket, the security guard on the other side said I'd be able to get straight in, but the guy here said no, I've got a queue up still. It's a massive queue. Is it really worth queuing up in it? Wow, I wasn't expecting to be this busy. That was a humongous queue, nearly put me off. I was thinking about going to the pub instead. But yeah, to be honest, it only took half an hour to get through. Just waiting, it was just a bottleneck at security. They wanted to check people's bags. I mean, I ain't got a bag with me, so why can't let people through if I haven't got bags? Why we have to queue up? With all the bag searches is gone, but anyway, I'm through now, so looking forward to it. Egyptian sculptures, Assyrian sculptures, Greece, Minoan Crete, and Mycenaeans. Right, they're back in Cairo. Oh, Assyria. now we're back in Cairo, I think. This is the Egyptian bit. Egypt. Now into ancient Greece and Rome.
Thank you.
The Amazon freeze. Ancient Greece. Non galleries. seems to show you.
Gente morta aí, né?
Não sei por que agora. Oi.
the British Museum overwhelmed such a big place. I've not seen it all. I would have liked to have gone to the Legion, the Roman Legion exhibition, but that was extra on top of the entrance or open to members, but it was fully booked for today, so couldn't get in there. Yeah, too much to see in one day, far too overwhelming. Deserved a few visits. I think maybe come and study a subject you're into, one of the exhibitions or two in depth. I've had a bit of a rush round and it's been a sensory and information overload. Lovely. Yes, definitely worth the half an hour wait in the queue to get in. It's free to enter by paid a £5 donation, or if you're going to come often, you can become a member, and that gets you access to all of the paid exhibitions as well. Really worth a visit. I really enjoyed that. Like I say though, sensory overload. Got that it was a bit much for me in the end. So coming out, we've got to find something to eat and a little drink, and then back to the hostel and tube to the O2 for the smashing pumpkin. Let's go. So I was pretty hungry, went for the Lyon at the Brunswick Centre. Bit expensive, but it's nice. I've had a smoky paprika chicken wrap, crisscross fries, and some breaded mushrooms, a couple of sauces there to go with it, and a Coke. Can't wait to dig in. Oh, so as you can see, it's a bit awkward to make the bed. Change the colour of the lights. don't have it. Plug sockets. So that was the British Museum of Free Palestine March. I've shown you my room. I made my bed for later, so I'm not going to do it when I get in, waking everyone up. Next stop, the O2 Arena for the Smashing Pumpkins. I'm going to catch a tube there. It's the Northern Line, I think, and then the Jubilee. So one change. Northern Line and then the Jubilee. 25 minutes it's going to take. It is 4:15, so I'll be there before the doors open. Might get a chance to get a quick pint in before the fun starts.
This station is London Bridge. Change here for Jubilee Line and National Rail Service. Never been here. Thought it was just wasteland. Look at all these buildings. Very modern. Greenwich Peninsula. Biltong Boss. Thank you.
So I think I forgot to film an outro last night for the video. Had a lovely day, visited the British Museum, stumbled across the Palestine March, and went to see the Smashing Pumpkins and Weezer and Teen Mortgage at the O2 Arena. It was fantastic. The Smashing Pumpkins certainly didn't disappoint. So yeah, had a really lovely day, and also had a good night's sleep in the pod hostel, the Clink 261. I've stopped in two Clink hostels now, the one in Dublin, now the one in London. I think there's two in London, and there's also one in Amsterdam, so I've got a couple of those to tick off at some point in the future. Oh, there's a shard, wow. Yeah, so next day today, and a new video. Cheers.